Hey, y'all. Hello, how you doing today? Hope you're doing good. I know I am. I just got over a cold. Luckily, I have a very good immune system, however. People say smokers have bad immune systems. Well, clearly not, because I get sick like once a year. And when I do get sick, I'm only sick for 2 or 3 days. Never even been sick for 4 days. 2 or 3 and then I'm better. Whereas a lot of people, people claim smoking makes it linger. I don't know. I take multivitamins. That probably helps the vitamin C, and I'm also drinking orange juice. Healthy choice. Don't you just hate people who sip like that so unnecessarily? They're just like... It's disgusting. Stop! So, I reviewed Wild Rum, Vanilla, and Grape, which are 3 of the discontinued backwoods flavor, and here I am today to finish off this, this is the last discontinued flavor that I haven't yet reviewed, which I'm glad to be reviewing, that I could get my hands on. Backwoods Banana Cigars. Let me tell you about these. These are very hard to find online. I don't know why. They're discontinued in the U.S. I think they still make them in other places. I ordered these from Australia. But I spent countless hours on Google, searching, trying to find a website. Finally found one. I was finally able to get a pack, and I was very excited. So again, you'll notice with these ones, it says mild and natural instead of wild and mild, and the warning label, that's harsh. Don't let children breathe your smoke, and then it shows like a dying child. It's a little harsh. I don't think your child's going to be like that at that age from secondhand smoke, unless they're allergic to cigarette smoke. But I don't think that's the most common allergy. It's like, why don't they put that shit on peanut butter? A lot of kids are allergic to peanut butter, but they don't have any warnings on them, do they? No, they don't! Gotta get the list out. Yeah. Where to start? I'm in a crazy mood right now. Crazy mood. So a bit of an update on the diet. The diet's good. It's going well. Drinking healthy fluids, no soda, no caffeine, no salt. I haven't used salt since 2009, though. No junk food, healthy food, exercise in a bit. It's going well, and I appreciate all the nice comments all of you left. I really did appreciate that, because that does help the willpower, and it makes me feel good and motivated. So thank you. You all rock. I do mean that. Just let me take another swig of the OJ here. I don't know. Bad enough I laugh at my own jokes, but... Well, I guess I wasn't really making a point there. I just laugh at my own jokes. You gotta keep yourself entertained. And I think when you have ADHD, that's a great advantage of it, is keeping yourself entertained with your hyperactivity. Definitely does. Presentation. Well, first of all, instead of being like the wow... What's the word? The wow bubble with, you know, the spiky edges like it does on the honeyberry. This, the banana's actually in a banana, which is, you know. Other than that, it's just a yellow pack. Same as pretty much all of them. Just the rustic appeal, of course. And we have the paragraph, of course, on the back, as we always do, that I'm going to read. Years ago, when a man wanted a good cigar, he'd roll his own. Those cigars didn't look that refined, but they sure tasted mild and smelled good. Now you can enjoy the same kind of smoke with Backwoods. We take all natural filler tobacco, We take all natural filler tobacco, which is selected for mildness. Then we roll it in gentle tasting broadleaf, a dark tobacco that is aged for at least 12 months to bring out its naturally sweet taste and pleasing aroma. I'm going to do my normal voice from this point forth. We make them like they used to, Backwoods banana cigars. Okay, so I've already opened it. I've only smoked one out of this pack. Let me tell you, it says to tear it, rip here and then rip across. I have OCD, and I need everything to be organized. It just comes on too uneven if I do that. So what I do is I take my Swiss Army knife and I take the little scissors, and I just cut along that dotted line, because I'm just so neat like that. I guess that's just my preference, I don't know. So the scent, it's an odd scent. It to me, these have never smelled like actual banana. It almost has a peachy smell to it. It smells kind of like peach to me. I don't know why that is, but it is. Don't question it.
Fold flat back twice to seal in freshness.
Yeah. These cigars are fairly fresh. You can tell it's pretty dark. Yeah, it's the peachy smell. Flavor. First of all, you know, most backwoods have the flavoring on the end here, other than like the original flavors or the sweet aromatic or black and sweet aromatic or whatever. And then all the other ones do. This one has a very slight taste. And it's not really banana, it's just kind of a sweet, sugary taste. It's vague though, which is good. I don't like when they overdo it. So that's actually a good part anyway. So let's light it up and shut the fuck up here. Don't you just hate these lighters? These lighters suck. The only reason I have them is because my friends always bring them over. See, it still has fluid in there and it's not even lighting. Come on. And it goes out on me for no reason. There we go. Now all the backwoods taste like what they are. Vanilla tasted like vanilla, wild rum tasted like rum. You know, grape tasted like grape, honeyberry tastes like honeyberry, honey tastes like honey, so on and so forth. But with these ones, I've really, and I've only had about four or five packs of these in my lifetime. These aren't one that I smoke that often, especially not now that it is discontinued, of course, but nonetheless, they've never tasted like banana to me. They almost just taste like the original backwoods. They don't taste fruity like the other fruits do. They don't possess that much of a flavor. Backwoods, you usually light them up and that fruit flavor just jumps out at you. It just takes you and grabs you in. You know, and gets you addicted. You know, like it's heroin. Not really. Well, I don't know. Nicotine is pretty addictive. I wouldn't exactly compare it to heroin. Heroin can kill you by taking just that too much. Tobacco takes years to kill you. If it does kill you. What was I talking about? It's the problem with ADHD. Your mind's... I didn't take my medication. My medication's worn off at the moment. So I'm a little bit all over the spectrum. Was I talking about the flavor? Oh yeah, I was saying how the fruit flavors jump out at you. Yeah, but this one really doesn't. It doesn't taste that much different than original, except for the flavoring on the end of the wrapper and the scent. So the flavor, you know, don't expect it to taste like banana. But then again, you know, I don't really think that banana is a very common flavor for cigars. I've never seen another brand. They might be out there, but if they are, they don't sell them around here. So, for it being the only banana cigar, I think they should have done better. I can understand why they discontinued them in the U.S. They bombed. They didn't sell that well. I remember back in freshman year when I still smoked cigars before I switched to cigarettes and then to dip and then came back to smoking cigars and dipping, you know, in that period where I just smoked cigars during freshman year. Every time I would get a pack, they'd be hard as a rock. You could take it and snap it in half just like that. Like a fucking twig. So that should tell you that they never sold. And I didn't go to the same store, I'd go to different stores. I even went to Florida, and my brother Matt bought me a pack. And it was still the same, so I think they kind of bombed, so yeah. Comparison, like I said, there's no real banana cigars out there, I don't think, besides these. And to me, this doesn't taste like banana, it just tastes like the original backwoods. Maybe a little sweeter, but not that much different. So that kind of sucks. Strength is typical with backwoods. Smoke isn't too harsh on the throat, it's pretty mild. Strength is good. You know, they compared to cigarettes, they have more nicotine in them, so if you're used to cigarettes and you try inhaling these, then They might be a little harsh for you, but for me, I don't even feel anything. Also, I got a suggestion on here from a friend. I'm currently forgetting his username, but he said I should do vlogs, and vlogging's something I've always been interested in, but I never had a good enough camera for it. Well, I finally invested in a good camera. $150 of my birthday money spent well, instead of most teenagers who spend it on weed and cheese doodles. I actually spent it on something productive. It's the Canon PowerShot ELPH300HS. And it's an HD camera. It's a good camera. It's one of the best-selling Canon cameras, and it's very, very popular among YouTubers who vlog, like professional ones, not like the shitty vlogs, you know what I mean. Comes with a bunch of wires, USB hookups, TV hookups, all that kind of stuff. Battery charges, CD software manuals. But here's the actual camera. It's very slim, very lightweight, very nice. Nice big screen here. Turn it on. You can't really see it, but it does. It takes excellent pictures and video. So I'm going to start doing occasional vlogs. I'm not going to vlog about like an ordinary day just sitting here smoking. But when I do something exciting, which February vacation is coming up here. Friday is my last day before vacation. And Sunday I'm going to Providence, Rhode Island. I think I'm going to vlog the hell out of that because I love Providence and that'll be something exciting. So look for that. That'll be good. Back to the smoke. The smoke amount you get is typical backwoods. Excuse me. I've been burping a lot. Sorry. And all my videos, like my past 5 or 6 videos, I've done at least one huge burp. I don't know why. But the smoke amount, typical of backwoods, it's relatively thick. You know, after you have a couple, you might want to open up the windows. It's not too bad, though. The draw is pretty much perfect. You have that nice flow of air. You know, it's not too hard to draw smoke, not too easy. It doesn't come too easily, because that actually sucks. But so does having a bad draw, as in you just don't get enough smoke. Both of them suck. Backwoods are usually good. Sometimes they're wrapped just a tad too tight, and they'll be hard to draw smoke. But as for me, or not for me, for most backwoods cigars, I'd say like one out of a pack sometimes has a bad draw. For the most part, they're good though. Structure's good. The wrap is good. They have the hand-rolled appearance. It's actually wrapped in a broadleaf as opposed to paper like most cigars and cigarettes are. Cigars are just wrapped, or a lot of them are just wrapped in brown paper. And, you know, that's a lot worse for you than a natural leaf. But the wrap is good. Sometimes it comes undone a little bit, and all I have to do is lick it and pat it down, and it should be good. Take another swig! I love me some orange juice. Lightability is good, too. Lights right up, stays lit consistently. You'd have to put it down for a little while for it to go out on you. It stays lit pretty well. Last ability, as I say in all backwards reviews, 15 to 20 minutes. It's not, you know, it's perfect amount for me. For people who like bigger cigars, it might be kind of short, but for me, it's perfect. I'd say 15 to 20. Sometimes if they're not that fresh, I'd say 10 to 15, but for the most part, 15 to 20. And last but not least, the aftertaste. Not much there, just a smoky aftertaste, not like a bitter, just kind of a typical smoke aftertaste, nothing too bad. If you get an aftertaste you don't like, just drink something to wash it down, you know, other than water, milk, orange juice, soda, whatever it be. Also, people have been asking me to do pipe and pipe tobacco reviews. Well, they're coming real soon, so be on the lookout for that soon. You know, I like to do what my fans request. One thing I want to say is people have requested me in the past to do nasal snuff. I am not going to do that. I have no interest in trying that shit. It's a weird concept to me. That's just not something I take interest in. Plus, they don't even sell it around here. So anyone who wants me to do nasal snuff reviews, I'm sorry to say, I really don't want to do them. Not to disappoint, not to be an ass, but I'm just saying. All right, so the rating of Backwoods Banana Cigars. Honestly, they're probably my least favorite Backwoods flavor. I guess I would smoke them on occasion, but I don't love them. Yeah, they're just, you know, they don't taste like what they are. Like I said, most backwoods flavors jump out at you. These don't. They really don't taste like banana to me. So they're kind of a letdown. But they're not terrible. If every other backwoods flavor got discontinued and for some reason all they had was backwoods banana, I would have to cope with it. Cope, as in Copenhagen. But, yeah, I don't love them. So I'm going to give them a 7 out of the 10. Not terrible. Just, whatever. But thanks for watching this review. I hope you enjoyed. More coming soon. And the vlog and the pipe reviews all coming soon. Hope you enjoy them. Take care. Okay, guys. It's nighttime and everything, so it might not look that good. But I just wanted to record a preview video with my new Canon camera. What the hell? I have a fucking furball on there. So, yeah. I just wanted to show you what this camera looks like. And, yeah, it's nighttime, but it'll look much better once we're in Providence, and it's daytime. So look for that. I'm looking forward to vlogging it.